one individual, two different worlds. In the midst of the recent protests following George Floyd's death, many Black officers find themselves at the intersection of identity and their profession.
It makes me proud being a member of the Black law enforcement community, but it saddens my heart to see that in this day and age of 2020, that this is still an issue.
Go to the 7-Eleven, I got somebody walk, don't even notice guy, walks up, hands up, don't shoot, and looks at me, literally does this at the 7-Eleven. And you look at him like, you know, that wasn't me, right? That wasn't me who did that horrible thing. It wasn't me. Or the minority, or the African Americans, or men, or people of color look at you as like if you were a traitor to their people. Like, you know, I got into the profession because we need to see more of us in the profession.
The most recent data from the Bureau of Justice Statistics shows that about 11% of full-time officers in the U.S. are Black. So it's clear the majority of the officers don't reflect the communities that they serve.
But my fellow officers that are not of color, a majority of them cannot relate to it, you know, because it's not their experience. And when it's not your experience, you can never really understand it.
I grew up in Section 8. I was in a group home, foster care. I was in and out of homes as a kid. So I've seen it all. I can relate to these kids.
Based on what I've seen across the United States, I definitely believe that there has to be a change. And it starts with the departments. It starts with educating them. It starts with awareness. It starts with accountability, because that's very important.
My whole thought process is, you know, out of the four guys that is there, somebody should have helped that other one. Say, look, this man said he can't breathe.
If you stand idly by and do nothing, you have might as well join in, because you're going to go to jail for the same crime, for doing nothing. So you have an option. Your only option really is to stop that action. And we have officers today looking at me and go, well, I don't understand why they get charged. You know, well, apparently you guys don't pay attention to the use of force classes that we teach.
Sergeant Banton went on to explain that excessive force happens for three reasons: fear, anger, and lack of training. And with the recent trends, a shift in training is needed.
I've never known any police officers to be taught to place your knee on someone's neck to control them.
Some of the online training that I'm proposing is that, you know, we look at some de-escalation training. So I'm hoping that this case in Minnesota will be have a disposition so that we can use that case as a case study in the upcoming training as it relates to use of force. Use of force for us is generally a quick, you know, topic, and we move on. Because everybody kind of knows what use of force is and what we should and shouldn't do. But I'm realizing now that we need to expand upon it. We need to show multiple videos and give scenarios.
I asked each officer what it would mean to defund the police.
I think if you defund the police, now who you going to rely on to protect your constitutional rights, so to speak? So if we're not upholding the law, who will?
If there aren't any law enforcement in the community, then that'll be total anarchy. So the police are needed.
At the end of the day, we need more officers on the street. But now you have officers on the street that don't get the training that you, the citizen, are requiring of them because of defunding. So is that an answer? I don't think so.
Regardless of what position you take, the reality is, without action, we can't expect to see any change.
Somehow, some way, the police have to get back out there and show that we are here for the people.
The police officers are here because they want to make a difference, and they love the community. And it's just not about pay for them. They really want to help people. But like I said, there are a few bad apples in every bunch, in every profession.
You know, it's our job to have the community's trust, and it's our job to show it to them. It's not their job to show it to us. It's our job to show it to them. We work for them.